वेलकम टू गेट कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड यूजीसी नेट कंप्यूटर साइंस स्टूडेंट्स. इन टुडे टॉपिक आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग पार्ट टू फॉर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड अल्गोरिथम. एंड सो इफ यू वांट टू आई मीन फॉलो मी फॉर मोर प्रॉब्लमेटिक क्वेश्चन एंड इट्स सॉल्यूशन विथ प्रॉपर एक्सप्लेनेशन, you can follow in this YouTube channel the NTA UGC net and CSA and GATE CS. Okay, you try to subscribe this channel so that I will be updating. And if you want to contact me for any queries and anything, you can write a mail to this email. Okay, so now I'm continuing part 2 for data structure and algorithm. Okay, so the question was elements 42, 20, 30, 40, 22, 35, 26 are inserted one by one in given order into a max heap. The resultant max heap is stored in array implementation. Okay, so I want to explain you what is called max heap. Okay, max heap is the heap tree in which you want to place the data in such a way that every root node, either it is a final root node or internal root node, you should keep maximum or larger value than its child. Okay, so that is the max heap. If it is min heap, it is reverse process. Okay, root node must have minimum value as compared to its child. Okay, then it is said to be min heap. Okay, so now our task is you want to represent max heap. First I want to keep 42, then 25 is coming. Okay, so I want to explain how to construct this heap tree. Okay, once we placing root node, then you want to follow top to bottom and then left to right. Okay, so every root must have two child like that. You want to keep top to bottom, left to right. Now 25 is coming. I'm placing here. Okay, actually this is the resultant final answer, but for this 42 I want to keep 25 here. Okay, after that 30 is coming, I want to keep here. Okay, but you are seeing 35, it is not a final one. Okay, so now 40 is coming, I want to place here. Okay, actually we are keeping 25 here, 40 here. Now we want to compare max heap process. Previously for this 42, 25 here, 25 lesser than 42, no issue. Like that 30 here, which is less than this 42, no issue. Okay, now once fourth element 40 we are placing here, which is greater than this 25. So here root element having lesser value than its child, so you want to call EPBY process. What is EPBY process? Is it will swap the data between two node in such a way that it will make proper arrangement. Okay, now this 40 must go there, this 25 must come here, so this EPBY process will do. Okay, once it is over, 22 is coming. So actually 25 properly came here, 40 properly came here. Now I want to place 22 here. Okay, again I'm comparing with this 40. 22 is less than 40, no issue. Okay, then what is coming? 35 I'm placing here. Previously 30 there, I'm placing 35 there. Now what happened? This 35 is greater than this 30, so it is not in max heap. So we are calling EPBY process. This will swap this 35 and 30. So here actually we place 35, this go here. Here actually we place 30, it come here. Okay, and finally 26 is coming, so I'm placing here. So I'm comparing with 35, so it is lesser, so no issue. So we constructed max heap. So now you want to write this max heap data as in array format. So from top to bottom procedure, left to right. Okay, 42, 40, 35 and then 25, 22, 30, 26. Okay, so this is placed in option D. So option D is correct. Okay, so now once it is over, and we want to come to next question, and that is, I mean, longest common subsequence. There will be provided two, list or sequences. Okay, they'll be asking which is common element, common between this X and Y with the highest length. Okay, so now what we have to do here is, I'll be taking very simple procedure telling. Okay, so here 0 initially first element present, like that 1 is present here. Okay, now if suppose we are taking the 0 for common sequence, for longest sequence, then where we can find out 0 in Y is only here. Okay, if I take this 0, this 0, okay, and two more element only possible for next subsequence. Okay, between 1 and 0, after this 0, I can take this as 1 and this as 0, I can finish off. Okay, but what happen is, length only 3. Okay, so you can, that is also one of the longest common subsequence, but better than this 3 element. Okay, we want to check whether it is possible or not. Okay, for that, if you are skipping the 0, now there is a 1, so we can take this one here, and for this Y we can take this one here. Now immediately we can take this 2 here. For that, we'll be having these 2. Okay, so for elements are 1 and 2, the length is 2. Okay, now immediately I can take this 1, and for that I can take this one from this in between 0 there, we can omit that, no problem. Like that we can omit this 3, I can take this 0, and like that I can take this 0. Okay, so now 4 elements common between this X and Y, so 4 is length, great, I mean longest common subsequence. Okay, so now option A is very correct. Okay, so next question, what it was. So consider array here, that is elements are 4, 1, 3, 2, 16, 9, 10, 14, 8, 7. After building heap from the array, the depth of heap and right child for max heap are, okay, they're asking. Okay, so we already know what is called max heap. Okay, how to approach this one. Okay, so I told, right, first we are placing this 4 here. Okay, this is a final result. Okay, so we are placing 4 here, then we are placing 1 here. So now 1 is less than this 4, no issue. Again, it have 3. I'm placing the 3 here. Again, 3 is less than this 4, no issue. Now 2 is coming, I'm placing here. Sorry, placing here. Okay, now what happened? This here we have 1, and here we am placing 2, but 2 is greater than 1, so I'm swapping. So 2 will come here, and then 1 is coming here. Okay, now 16 come here, where we want to place. I'm placing 16 here, but what happened here is, here we have 2, here 16, but 16 is greater than this 2, so swapping. So 2 is coming here and 16 go there. Okay, now again 16 is greater than this 4, so I'm swapping 16 here, and 4 coming here. Okay, so now what happened, so far 16, here 4, here we'll be having 1, here we are having 2. Okay, and right side we'll be having, previously we done 3. Okay, so now what happened, 9 is coming, where we want to place 9 should be placed, I mean, so here for this two child already represented. Now you want to keep up here. Okay, now what happened? Here 16 properly went to there. So now 9 we want to place. I mean, actually here it we have actually 3 here. For that you want to keep where you want to keep 9. Okay. So for that what happened is 9 supposed to kept somewhere I mean here, and then 10 is coming. Okay, so now I try to place 10 here. So for that what happened is what happened here is, sorry, before this 10 actually 3 here. Okay, once we are placing 9, so it should be I mean rearrange, right? Okay, now what happened, actually 3 is there, 9 is there. Okay, 9 greater than this 3, so I want to perform I mean EPY process. So this will swap 9 to this place and 3 to this place, and then 10 is coming. So now I'm trying to place here, but 9 here. Okay, 9 is less than this 10, so we want to swap 10 to this place, 9 to this place. Okay, so perfectly it is now. And 14 coming, I'm trying to place here. So actually what happened, actually 16 properly settled here, and then 4 is here, or that 1 here. Okay, so now what you want to do here is I'm placing this 14 I mean here. So but what happened is, you want to EPY, because here we will be having 1, but so this 14 is greater, so I'm placing here again. This 14 is greater than this 4, so I want to place this 14 here, and 4 will come here. Okay, so now 8 is coming there, and I want to place right side, but 8 is greater than this 4, so I want to place 8 here, 4 here. Okay, and then 7 is coming, but here we have 2. Okay, so now 7 placed here, but if you are comparing 7 with 2, 7 is greater, so I want to place the EPY process. Okay, so now 7 will go there, 2 will come there. Okay, our task is over. Now they are asking two question, right? Depth is what? This one is one depth, I mean one child, two child for this one, and then again two child there, and like that. Here if you are coming to left side, length is 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 is depth, and then they are asking what is the right child to this max if. Okay, what is the right child to this max if 16? 10. Okay, 10 is answer. Okay, so depth of this max if is 3, and right child of this max if is 10. Okay, so here 3 comma 10 is there, that is a correct answer. Okay, so next one is a hash function. Okay, so what is this hash function? Hash function is one of the technique used in data structure to store properly in such a that we can easily take out without any difficulty. And for that they are using function h of hash of key equal to key mod 7. Okay, what is this 7? Okay, the number of in array, number of data stored will be 7 datas. Okay, so this will be used in linear probing concept. Okay, so they are having the key data as this data 44 45 79 55 91 18 63, and you want to place it in this hash table. Okay, with the indexing of this hash table is 0 to 6, totally 7 element. What will be location of 18 be placed? Okay, and this is very simple. So first data is 44, we are replacing this key as 44. 44 mod 7 is what? How many time 7 is 42. 42 6 times there, remainder is 2. Sorry, that remainder 2 is nothing but that is the low index value where in which you want to place the 44. Okay, so remainder is 2, so 2 is the this position, there we want to place this 44. Okay, and next what is the data coming? 45. Okay, 45 mod 7 is 3, and third position in which we want to place this 45, and then 79 coming, so 79. Okay, 77, 11 time there, and remainder is 2. Okay, now what happened is and this 2 already having 44 as data, then immediately where we want to place this 79. Okay, so we want to place right to this particular second position, but unfortunately this third position has also having the data, so I want to place next to this one 79 in fourth position. Actually the position in which we supposed to place 79 is second position, but it already filled. I am coming to right again, it is already filled, I am coming to right. Okay, that way we want to place. Okay, and next one is 55 you want to place. For that I am calculating 55 mod 7, which is nothing but 6, sixth location empty, so I am placing it. Okay, again next one is 91, and this 91 what happened, what is the remainder? So 10 times 7 is 70, and 3 times 7 is 21. Okay, 70 plus 21 91, and remainder is 0, and this have empty position, I am placing it. Okay, and next data is 18, so this is where we want to place, that is our question. So now 18 mod 7 is 4. Okay, now 4 already filled with the 79, so where we want to fill very immediately to its right. Okay, fifth position already vacant, I am placing here. Okay, so now 5 is the answer. Okay, okay, so next one is the following number are inserted into empty binary search in given order 10, 1, 3, 5, 15, 12, 16. What is the height of binary search tree? Okay, what is binary search tree? Binary search tree is the search tree technique in which you want to place a root and then its corresponding, if you are placing first element as root, then you want to place rest of the data in such a way that, okay, if it is lesser than this 10, then you want to keep to left to this particular 10. If it is greater than, then you want to keep up right to this particular 10. Okay, so that is the concept. Okay, now 10 is coming, I am placing here. 1 is coming, 1 is less than 10, I am placing here. Okay, now 3 is coming, I am comparing 3 with 10. Okay, now 3 is less than 10, coming to left. Again we placed 1 here. I want to compare 3 with this 1. Okay, now what happened? So this 3 greater than this 1, I want to keep right to this particular 1. Okay, so why? Because this is act as the root node. Now for this 1 is lesser, it greater element is 3, so I want to keep as right data. Okay, now again 5 is coming, comparing with 10 lesser, I'm comparing with 1 greater, again I'm comparing with this 3, so now 5 is greater to this 3, and we want to keep us right child to this particular 3. Okay, so for how many data are this one. Okay, now 15 is coming, comparing with 10 greater, so I'm going here and placing here. Okay, now 12 is coming, comparing with 10 greater, and comparing with 15 lesser, I'm placing here. 16, comparing with 10 greater, right child, and then compare with the 15 greater, so right child I want to place. Okay, so now they are asking what is the height of this binary search tree. Okay, so length is 1 and length is 2, length is 3, it's totally 3. Okay, okay, so next one is post order traverse of given binary search tree T producing following sequence of key 3, 5, 7, 9, 4, 17, 4, 16, 20, 18, 15, 14. Which one of following sequence can be result of in-order Traversal tree? Okay, there is a very simple logic. Okay, if you are representing the binary search tree with in-order, then the data will be in sorted order. So that is the answer. Okay, no need to construct binary search tree. Okay, whichever sequence in ascending order, that is actually answer 3, 4, 5, 7, 9 up to 20. Okay, so look at here. So it is in sorted order. So in binary search tree, if you are representing in order binary search tree, it always in sorted order. Okay, so next question. Consider a full binary tree with n internal nodes, internal path length I and external path length E. The internal path length of full binary tree is sum taken over all nodes of tree of depth each node. Similarly, external path is the sum taken all leaves of tree of depth of leaf. Okay, which of the following is a full binary tree? Okay, so if you are representing full binary tree, then there is a formula, that is a number of external node equal to number of internal node into number of internal node plus 2 into how many number of internal node present in your binary tree. Okay, so here I'll be explain very clearly. Suppose we have this as the full binary tree. Okay, you know what is full binary tree. Full binary tree is nothing but you want to place top to bottom, left to right in such a way that you want to complete it. Okay, so now internal path I. Okay, what is internal path I for? Now what are the internal nodes here? A, B, C. Okay, now what is the degree of this particular internal path A? Okay, plus degree of internal path B, degree of internal path C. Okay, so now what is that? Okay, here this level is what actually. Nodes going, okay, so it is what, 0. Okay, now what about this B? Okay, so which mean what is the meaning? I mean, for this A, no more root node there. Okay, so it is 0, but for B, its root node is A, so one path there. Okay, that is 1. For that C also 2A, one path there, that is 1. Okay, totally how many internal node? 3. But internal path length I is nothing but 0 plus 1 plus 1 2. Okay, like that external path length E, which can be what are the external path? So which is nothing but leaf node D E F G. Okay, so now external path length, what is this for this D? Okay, towards this root node A, 1, 2. Okay, like that for E, A to B, B to E. Okay, 2. Okay, and then degree of this F is what? F to C and C to A, 2 again. Okay, and like that degree of this G is what? A to C, C to A, 2. Okay, so if you are adding all 8, so we can see that E equal to I plus 2n. Okay, but n is nothing but number of internal nodes A, B, C. Okay, so now E equal to what? E already calculated, that is 8. 8 equal to I is what? I equal to 2. Okay, we calculated here, plus 2 into n is nothing but 3. Okay, 2 plus 2 into 3, 8. Okay, so now what is the formula required to represent this full complete और फुल ट्री बाइनरी ट्री इज नथिंग बट ऑप्शन बी. ओके सो आई विल बी टेकिंग दिस एज लास्ट क्वेश्चन. कंसिडर द रेकरेंस रिलेशन टी ऑफ एन प्लस इक्वल टू ए टी ऑफ एन बाई टू प्लस सी एन. ओके एंड वेर ए बी एंड सी आर कॉन्स्टेंट द ऑर्डर ऑफ अल्गोरिथम करस्पॉन्ड टू अबोव रेकरेंस रिलेशन दे आर आस्किंग. ओके एक्चुअली इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी रेकरेंस रिलेशन लाइक दिस विद I mean, I want to explain here. Okay, so this position, whatever value the present is nothing but a, and n slash. Okay, whatever data, I mean value present is nothing but b. Okay, that you want to keep in mind, and this is actually function is called f of n. Okay, so if you are having t of n equal to a into t of n by b plus f of n, then your time complexity will be three kind, either this one, or this one, with respect to its condition satisfaction. Okay. Now, if you want to take time complexity of the any recurrence relation with the n power log of a to base b, whenever your f of n, this f of n should be getting through this formula. Okay, which means you want to calculate. Big O of n power log a minus epsilon, where epsilon is some constant to the base b. Okay, so then if you are getting this calculation as f of n whatever present there, then this is your time complexity. Okay, so usually when go for this option is whenever this a is greater than b. If a equal to b, a equal to b, then you want try to get f of n as this one. Okay, if you are getting f of n this one, then time complexity is this one. Okay, or a less than b, then you want to compute whether this f of n getting as this expression. Otherwise, you want to calculate this formula. If you are getting answer as f of n, then this is your time complexity. Okay, so now I want to explain with its example. You take a, I mean now as per this given problem, a equal to 8, a equal to 8 here and b equal to 2 here. Okay, now a greater than b, which mean first case is answer. Okay, now I mean we cannot blindly take this as time complexity or order of relation. If you want to take this as order of relation, this computation supposed to give exactly f of n as n. Okay, if you are getting n as answer here, then I can take this as time complexity. Okay, now I want to check it. Okay, and O of n power log of 8 minus epsilon to the base b. B is nothing but 2. Okay, now in order to get n as f of n, what do you want to do? You want to subtract some value from this 8 such that it is equal to b. Okay, because log a to the base a, then what happened? It's equal to 1, which means I'm taking log 2 base 2, okay, which is equal to 1. Okay, so now what happened? So n power log of 8 minus 6. Okay, here I want to substitute epsilon as 6. Why? My task is I want to make it as f of n, because already I know a is greater than b. I want to make it as expression as f of n. Okay, when how I can do log of 8 minus 6 to base b. Okay, 8 minus 6 is nothing but 2, so log of 2 base 2 equal to 1, so n power 1 equal to n, so now which is nothing but f of n. Okay, so I'm able to do that one. So our order of relation is what? N power log 8 to base 2. Okay, Now we have suppose we have log of 2 power 2 base 2. Then this power we can keep it as left to this log, okay, which mean 2 log 2 base 2. Are you getting or not? Log of, okay, 2 power 2 base 2. I can rewrite this as 2 into log of 2 base 2, okay. So now here what happened, n into, sorry, n power log of 8 to base 2, okay. We can rewrite this as log of 8 is nothing but 2 cube, 2 cube base 2, okay. This cube is nothing but I am putting before this log, so it is what, 3 into log of 2 base 2, okay. So which is nothing but log of 2 base 2 is nothing but 1, 3 into 1 is nothing but 3, n power 3 is the answer, okay. So now this is your answer, okay. I am stop here, okay. So okay, thank you for watching.